First Things First is sponsored by Gillette, the best a man can get.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Friday. Welcome to First Things First. I'm Jenna Wolf. He is the Hall of Famer, Chris Carter. This is Nick Wright. Great show for you today. We had some basketball last night, which will carry us through the next 3 hours. One place to start, and it is the reason my partner here lost some money last night.
You don't even know if that's true, Jenna Wolf. You asked me 30 seconds ago.
I fact-checked.
You don't even know.
Great dress, Jenna.
Thank you. Great tie, CC. Nick, you're looking dapper. Game one of the NBA Finals took place last night. Warriors, Raptors, and Toronto's Pascal Siakam was the star in this one. We said Kawhi would need someone else to step up, and Siakam did. Spicy P led Toronto 32 points as the Raptors won at 118-109. Steph had 34 points. Klay chipped in 21, but that wasn't enough as the Warriors drop game one of the finals. First time they've lost game one in the finals during this dynasty. In fact, here's your game one star, Pascal Siakam.
We know the team we're playing. We're playing an amazing team. They're the champions, and we just got to be ready. We won game one. We came out with a lot of, you know, it was really aggressive, you know, on defense and trying to make it tough for the players, you know, to find open shots. But, you know, we know that it's game one, and they're going to come out. They're going to make adjustments, and we got to be ready for that.
He played amazing game, obviously, but, you know, he got out in transition a lot. Our transition D was horrible, and I let him get in the rhythm in the first half, first quarter, really. So I got to do a better job of taking his rhythm away, and I will. But, you know, he had a great game, but that's on me.
Down 0-1, but it's not the end of the world. You know, new experiences for us all the way through, but, you know, we've proven our resiliency and ability to win games that we need to and kind of answer the bell and learn from, you know, nights like tonight.
Warriors don't have to use the word resilience very often, but Nick, let me start with you. How did the Raptors do it? How did they win game one?
Pascal Siakam and the Raptors defense were ready for NBA Finals intensity, and the Golden State Warriors were not. The Portland Trailblazers didn't do Golden State any favors except for the added rest. Golden State clearly thought, we'll go on a run. Oh, we're down at halftime? Okay, we were down at halftime in game two, in game three, in game four in the previous series. It was no problem. The Raptors' defense would not allow them to go on that run. The Warriors' defense wouldn't allow them to go on that run because at no point last night did they show any interest in getting back in transition or semi-transition, which Steve Kerr was just beside himself about during and after the game. And then there was a star turn for Pascal Siakam. Throughout the year, a lot of people were talking about D'Angelo Russell as the most improved player, and he was probably the most improved prominent player. But on this show, we talked about the kid in Toronto, Pascal Siakam, how he went from being a 7-point-a-game guy to a 16-point-a-game guy with a legitimate claim to be on an all-defensive team. And he was spectacular last night. In a game where Golden State had a very clear strategy that we're not going to let Kawhi Leonard beat us, and that was one thing they were actually able to execute, Pascal Siakam, who's got a lot of young Kawhi Leonard in his game, a lot of similarities there, took advantage of the fact that after in round two, he's got 6'11 Ben Simmons guarding him. And in round three, he's got 6'11 Giannis guarding him. Now he's got regular-sized NBA player Draymond Green guarding him.
Self-proclaimed best defender in the history of the NBA.
History of the world, Draymond Green. And Pascal Siakam gave him that work. And it was critical. It was the reason, to me, the biggest reason the Raptors won. It's why the Raptors were able to score with Golden State. And you had pointed out all week leading up to it, Chris, that Toronto that can't lose game one. They can't give away home court immediately.
Yes.
They didn't give away a quarter last night. They led wire to wire in this game, essentially, and Pascal Siakam's the biggest reason.
And Draymond makes a great point, though, in the soundbite, talking about the Warriors and how they decided to try to win this game was they're not going to let Kawhi Leonard get off. But Kawhi decided that I'm not going to be an unselfish player, and I'm going to try to make the right play. Even though he took some tough shots, a typical superstar like Kawhi, he's going to get up 24 to 27 shots in that game. But Kawhi didn't. Even though he played the type of minutes you didn't, he decided that, you know, I'm going to get other people involved. And after a slow start and turning the ball over, creating those open looks gave the other Raptors, confidence. Mark Gasol, he got off in that first quarter. Siakam, not only in the first quarter, but in the second quarter, he got into a rhythm. He got some easy looks. He got out into the fast break. And there were some things in this game that I was totally surprised at. And Jenna, you and I talked about it early this morning as far as Nick Nurse coming into this series. He's probably the least as far as important things as far as coaching. We just assume, oh, Steve Kerr, with all his experience. Nick Nurse, a journeyman coach, first year in Toronto. Their season's over with. It's been great taking this franchise there. But the adjustments that he made going into game number one, I think, led to the win, and that was the pace and how they were going to start the game.
Yeah, and one of those things is the transition. And Draymond said afterwards, we got beat in the transition game. And Pascal said, the reason I was able to play so well is because I was able to get back so quickly on transition. Was that the biggest difference, do you think, in this game?
Well, the biggest thing and one of the keys Nick had was the rebounding. They have to win the rebounding battle. And in going against Golden State, people talk about, oh, they're going to shoot threes. They're going to move the ball around. Everyone's going to set picks for Steph and for Klay. But yes, the other thing they do besides free throw shooting that kills you, it's their offensive rebounding or second chance points. And if you're going to the offensive board trying to get offensive rebounds, trying to get second chance points, and the thing that I missed in Nick Nurse, because I said they need to slow the pace down, make sure this game is slow. No, he told them from the beginning, we're going to attack, we're going to run. I was like, wow, they're going to run themselves into a very quick death.
Because we said coming in, what the Raptors have to do is slow down the Warriors
game. I thought they were playing into the Warriors' hand. I thought they were, because early in the game, they were giving up offensive rebounds. Was Toronto gave up 5 in the first quarter. They were trying to play at a pace with Golden State, and I thought they would wear out and Golden State would punch them.
And Golden State, typically, teams have tried to do this, but when they try to outrun Golden State, they try to outshoot them. There's a difference in outrunning them because with Steph and with Klay, they shoot the ball from diagonal and from the corner an awful lot. You're not going to have a balanced defense, so they're out of position. If they don't get an offensive rebound or a second chance, you have the ability to go on the attack. And that's what Nick Nurse and this coaching staff realized in the two games that they played earlier this year. They played at a faster pace. We saw Toronto slow down Milwaukee, and Milwaukee we thought was just a sample size of what Golden State was going to do. But, man, we were totally wrong. Nick Nurse was up on this, and that first half, man, they pushed that pace. In the second half, they got back to more of a finals game, more like they played Milwaukee. But that first half, first 24 minutes, Nick, huge advantage in the pace of the game.
And, see, you mentioned Kawhi not forcing the issue, Kawhi recognizing like that most guys in his spot we're going to put up 20 plus shots. One of the reasons he didn't and was because he didn't have to. The Raptors had a lead the entire game. So Kawhi, the Warriors, I think, had a smart defensive game plan against Kawhi. And their game plan against Kawhi isn't why Pascal got off. It's not why they got out in transition. I think they will try to duplicate that. They need to get better on the rotations. They can't give Marc Gasol what Steve Kerr called dare shots. Those things, they can guard Kawhi that way and be better otherwise defensively. But if Pascal Siakam doesn't make 11 consecutive field goal attempts and isn't 14 of 17 from the field in the game, then maybe Kawhi feels like, man, oh, yeah, I got to take some of these shots.
Yes, I get pressed.
And so it was the Raptors continually getting stops and Siakam being so great defensively allowed Kawhi to a degree to ease himself into the game and just take, I know it's a cliche, but take what the defense gave him. And what the Warriors gave him was a 1-0 lead in the series.
I mean, Siakam was special in this game. How special, Nick? I know you always love. You hit me with this. Oh, man, this guy is one of 10.
Yeah.
This guy's one of Siakam, 1 of 3. First NBA Finals game, 1 of 3. Jordan, Allen Iverson to go 35-5. That's how special he was in game number 1.
Pascal Siakam, 32 points on 14 for 17 shooting. Toronto now has a 1-0 lead in this series over the Golden State Warriors. Coming up, can the Warriors bounce back in game 2? That's next on FS1. You can always check us out on the Fox Sports channel on Sirius XM. We're back right after this.
That Jordan game.
Spicy B.
Again,
that got me.